Hi, I'm Ashley and welcome to Subtracting Decimals. In this video, I'm going to show you how to subtract decimals. It is important that you first understand place value, including place value with decimals, like the tenths, hundredths, and thousandths places, and also understand how to add decimals and how to subtract with regrouping. If you already know all of those things, then you're ready to get started. Let's go. Okay, here is our first one. We have 6 7/10, and we're going to subtract 6 4/10. Okay, remember we have to line up our place value. It's easiest to do that by paying attention to the decimal, lining it up. So now we're going to subtract the tenths place first. 7 - 4 = 3. Then 6 - 6 = 0. And we're going to be sure to bring down our decimal point. So then our final answer is 0.3. Find that over here on the right, 0.3 or 3/10. Okay, our next one here is 41 3/10 - 35 9/10. 41.3. -35.9. Okay, now, just like regular subtraction, 3 is smaller than 9, so we cannot take 9 away from 3. We're going to have to borrow from the ones place. So I'm going to mark this out. That becomes a 0. So this becomes 13. So 13 - 9 = 4. Bring down our decimal. Now, can we take 5 from 0? No, we cannot. So we're going to have to borrow from the tens place. 4 becomes a 3. Bring 1 over. So 10 - 5 = 5. And then 3 - 3 = 0, so we don't have to write anything there. 5.4, or 5 4/10, is our final answer. Okay, our next one is 37 81/100. And we are subtracting 16 6/10. Notice I lined up the decimal. I did not move this all the way over to the right because I have to have the decimals line up. Sorry, I made it scribbly there. Okay, 1 - nothing here. It's like 1 - 0 = 1. And we have 8 - 6 = 2. Bring down our decimal. 7 - 6 = 1. 3 - 1 = 2. And then there we go, our final answer, 21 21/100. Right there. Okay, last one here, and this is a bit of a longer one and one where you'll really have to pay attention to lining up that decimal point. We are starting with 8.0579 and subtracting 7.97265. Now look at this, there are more decimal places in the bottom number than the top one. That is okay. It is just like having a 0 right here. So I'm just going to fill that in with a 0. So 5 taken away from 0, we cannot do that, so we need to borrow. 9 will become an 8, and that makes this a 10. 10 - 5 is 5. 8 minus 6 is 2. 7 minus 2, 5. 5 minus 7. Now, again, we can't do that, so we need to borrow. Now, can we borrow from the 0? No, we cannot. So we're going to have to come all the way over to the ones place, the 8, and borrow from it. The 8 will become a 7. That makes this a 10 here. Now we can borrow from the 10. 10 becomes a 9. And the 5 becomes a 15. So 15 minus 7 equals 8. 9 minus 9 is 0. Bring down my decimal point, and then 7 minus 7 is 0. So my final answer here is 0.08525. I look over here on the right and find my final answer there at the bottom. And that is it. And there you have it. We just finished learning subtracting decimals. Be sure to practice what you've learned with our fun online games and quizzes. Come back to watch this again if you need it. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.